Welcome back to Wild West Faith. Last week we talked about high noon showdowns, and while there weren't too many one-on-one showdowns like you see in the movies, there were plenty of gunfights. A gunfight would have taken nerves of steel and great courage, something very few men possessed even in the Wild West. That's why most gunfighters shot their enemies in the back. If you look at some of the Wild West greats and how they died, the people that took them out used cowardly means to do it. They didn't even face their opponents. Wild Bill Hickok was shot in the back while he was playing cards, and Billy the Kid was shot by someone waiting in the dark as he entered the room, so he never even had a chance to see who it was or draw his gun to return fire. And those two were considered two of the deadliest gunmen in Old West times. But the people that took them out didn't have the courage to face them. That's what makes a certain Bible story we've heard 100 times even more incredible. You see, back in the Old Testament, there was a showdown like you see in the Wild West movies. The bad guy came walking out from enemy lines and dared someone, anyone, to face him. For days, his challenge went unanswered. But one morning, a brave, courageous young man took to the battlefield to answer that call. We're talking about the story of David and Goliath today. You can find the story in 1 Samuel chapter 17. Where did these two men find the courage and confidence that so many Wild West gunfighters lacked? Well, for the bad guy, the answer is easy. The Bible says he's 9 feet 4 inches tall. It would be pretty easy to feel confident when you're bigger, stronger, and tougher than anyone else on the battlefield, right? He's a giant. He knew no one out there could defeat him in hand-to-hand combat. But the other person in the story, David, well, he's still just a boy in many ways, a humble shepherd who wrote psalms on his harp, but his confidence was in God. At the beginning of the story, David wasn't even allowed to go fight because he was the youngest of his brothers. So he was at home taking care of their sheep, and his father asked him to go take some food to his brothers who had joined the army battling the Philistines, which is the army Goliath was part of. So when David got there, Goliath was doing his usual morning taunting and yelling like he did every single morning. And David was shocked to hear it. None of the Israelites were standing up to him. And David's like, "What are you guys doing?" So he volunteered to go and take care of the problem. And the other soldiers were concerned because he's just a shepherd boy. And David says, "Well, I've protected the sheep from lions and bears, and God kept me safe then. He'll keep me safe now." So King Saul tries to put his armor on David to help protect him, but it was too heavy for David to move, so David said, "I can't wear this, I'm not used to it." So he went to a stream and he found 5 smooth stones, and he took his slingshot and he went out to face the giant. And when Goliath saw him, he laughed and he cursed David. He thought it was a joke. But David said, "I come to you with God at my side. I will defeat you, and this world will know that there is a God and this battle belongs to him." So Goliath charges at David, and David flings a stone from his sling, and it strikes Goliath in the forehead, and Goliath hits the ground. He was defeated. So David goes and cuts off Goliath's head using Goliath's own sword. Then when the Philistine army saw that their champion had died, they turned and ran away, and Israel was able to win that battle. David had the confidence to enter that battle with no armor, no military training, only a slingshot and stones in hand, because he knew that God was at his side and would help him bring down that giant. And God rewarded his faith and gave him the victory. I wonder how many of you are facing giants in your life. Maybe it's starting a new school year, maybe it's moving or an illness, a struggle within your family. Whatever giant you're facing, you don't have to run and hide. Ask God for confidence, ask him for wisdom. God will give you the direction you need and the courage to stand strong. A one-on-one showdown against a gunfighter or a giant is a no-win situation. But when you have God on your side, you can have the confidence to face any challenge. Ask God to be your strength. Ask him for the confidence that you need. Just like David, you can defeat that giant with God on your side. Will you pray with me? Lord, you know what giants we're all facing, and we know that with you on our side, we can defeat them. Will you go with us as we challenge them, Lord? Thank you for always being there. Thank you for giving us the courage to face everything, Lord. In your name, amen. I'll see you guys next week. Bye, guys.